Hi everyone, I am Pratima. Dear students, today we will discuss 15 questions which were asked in NDA 2019 set A 2019-1, which was based on probability. So let us learn 15 questions so that it will help you in future, in other examination also. Question number 1, it was 101, from a deck of 50 cards. Cards are taken out with replacement. So here you should concentrate on the word with replacement or without replacement. That's very important. What is the probability that the 14th card taken out is an ace? The options are 1 by 51, 4 by 51, 1 by 52, 1 by 13. So since it is with replacement, then it is same as your probability of an ace. So how many aces are there? Number of aces is 4. And what is the total cards? Is 52. So what will the answer? Answer will be 1 by 13. Where is 1 by 13? So D is the answer of this question. Next question, if A and B are two events such that probability of A is 0.5, probability of B is 0.6, probability of A intersection B is 0.4, then what is your complement of A union B, not A union B, equal to? Options are 0.9, 0.7, 0.5, and 0.3. So P A is given, P B is given, P A intersection B is given. So we can get P A union B. How much it will be? It will be P A, P B, minus P A intersection B. So it will be 0.5 plus 0.6 minus 0.4. It will be 0.7. Now its complement. Its complement is 1 minus A union B. So it will be 1 minus 0.7. How much it is? 0.3. So what is the answer? D is the answer. Next question. A problem is given to 3 students, A, B, C, whose probabilities of solving the problem are 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 1 by 4 respectively. What is the probability that the problem will be solved if they all solve the problems independently? Options are 29 by 32, 27 by 32, 25 upon 32, and 23 upon 32. So probability of solving for A is equal to 1 by 2. Probability of solving B is equal to 3 by 4, and probability of solving C is equal to 1 by 4. It is given. And they are solving independently. What is that the problem will be solved? The probability of problem will be solved, it is equal to complement of probabilities not solved. When probability of not solved means it is neither solved by A, not A, nor it is solved by B, not B, or not solved by C, and they are independent, so I can multiply them. So now what is the answer? You will get P not A. What is P not A? P not A is equal to 1 minus P A, that will be half. Then you will get P not B is equal to 1 minus 3 by 4, that will be your 1 by 4. P not C is equal to 1 minus 1 by 4, that will be 3 by 4. Just multiply them. So it will be 1 by 2 into 1 by 4 into 3 by 4. So how much you are getting? You are getting 1 minus 3 by 32. What is the answer? It will be 29 by 32. What is the answer? This is the answer. Next question. A pair of fair dice is rolled. What is the probability that the second dice lands on higher value than the first? The options are 1 by 4, 1 by 6, 5 by 12, and 5 by 18. A pair of fair dice is rolled. That means there are two dice. What is the probability that second dice lands on a higher value of first? That means here you are 1, 2, 3 up to 6. In second also 1, 2, 3 up to 6. Now, for first, the second will be the larger. So what is the possibility? It will be 1, 2, 1, for I am taking for 1. 1, 2, 1, 3 up to 1, 6. So how much it will be? It will be 5. For first I will take 2, then second it will be your 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. How many it will be? It will be 4. Similarly, if first is 3, then how many it will be? It will be 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. Because I am getting the second one is always greater than first. So it will be 3 only. And what about 4? It will be 4, 5, 4, 6. So now you must have developed the logic. It is 2. And for 5, it is only 1. That is 5, 6. So it is 1. And when you throw 2 dice, so what is the sample space? Sample space is 36. And what are the events you are getting? You are getting, and for 6, there will be no number, 0. So it will be 5 plus 4. 9 plus 3, 12 plus 2, 14 plus 1, 15. So 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1 is equal to 15. So this is your NA, favoring. So what will the probability? Probability of A is equal to 15 by 36. 15 by 36, if you will simplify, how much it will be? It will be your 5 by 12. Where is the answer? Answer is C is the answer. Next question is, a fair coin is tossed and a unbiased dice is rolled together. One coin and one dice. Fair coin. Now, what is the probability getting 2 or 4 or 6 along with the head? Here I am getting head and here I am getting your either 2, 4 or 6. That means they are independent event. So probability of head here is equal to how much? Now 1 by 2. And probability of 2, 4, 6, how much it will be? For the second event, it will be 3 by 6. 3 by 6 means 1 by 2. So what is the probability of head as well as 2, 4, 6? That means this will be multiplication because it is taking place continuously. Independently. So it will be 1 by 2 multiplies your 1 by 2. What is the answer? It will be 1 by 4. So the answers were, let us see the answers. It was 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 6. So which one will be the answer? Answer will be 1 by 4. So let me explain again. So these two events are event 1 and event 2 are independent. From event 1, I'm getting head. So PE1 getting head is 1 by 2. And for second, I'm getting 2, 4, 6. Here the sample space is 6. So it will be 3 by 6, 1 by 2. And when we are getting both the events and independently, I'll multiply their probability. So it will be 1 by 2 multiplies 1 by 2. This will be 1 by 4. Next is, A, B, C are three events. What is the probability that at least two of these events occur together? Options are P, A intersection B plus P, B intersection C plus C intersection A, P, A intersection B plus P, B intersection C plus P, C intersection A minus P, A intersection B intersection C. Option C is P, A intersection B, P, B intersection C, P, C intersection A minus twice of P, A intersection B intersection C. Option D is P, A intersection B, B intersection C, C intersection A minus 3 times of A intersection B intersection C. So let me draw a diagram. This is your A, this is your B, this is your C. Now when I get at least 2 or 3, this is at least 2 means 2 plus 3. So this will be the whole area. This will be the whole area. So how much is this? This will be A intersection B plus B intersection C plus C intersection A. This is A, B, C, D. All will be either 2 or 3. So A will be the correct. Next is if two independent events A and B are such that P A union B is 2 by 3, P A intersection B is 1 by 6. If P B is your less than P A, what is P B equal to? Options are 1 by 4, 1 by 3, 1 by 2, 1 by 6. So here P A is not given. Let it be X and let P B is equal to Y. P A union B is equal to 2 by 3. P A intersection B is equal to 1 by 6. Here is another expression is given, that is they are independent. When they are independent, that means P A intersection B is equal to P A into P B. So I am getting P A into P B is equal to your 1 by 6, or I am getting X into Y is equal to 1 by 6. This is equation 1. Next is, we know that PA plus PB is equal to PA union B plus PA intersection B. So X plus Y is equal to how much? It will be A union B is 2 by 3, intersection B is 1 by 6. Now it will be 6, 4 plus 1, 5 by 6. This is 5 by 6. Now you have two equation. One is x plus y is equal to 5 by 6. And another is x into y is equal to 1 by 6. You have to solve by any method. You can take any way. You can put here in place of y, you can put x 5 minus x this. Or yeah, I can take x minus y whole square is equal to x plus y whole square minus 4xy. So I'll get how much? It will be 25 by 36 minus 4 by 6. I'll get 1 by 36, or I'll get x minus y is equal to square root of 1 by 36 is equal to your 1 by 6. Now I need y, so I'll subtract it. Then I'll get twice y is equal to your, we are subtracting, so it will be 4 by 6, it will be 2 by 3. Then what will be y? Y is equal to 1 by 3. Y is equal to 1 by 3. So which one is the answer? Answer B is the answer. Next question. If two fair dice are rolled, and what is the conditional probability that first dice land on 6, given that sum of the numbers on the dice is 8? So given that is very important for your conditional probability. Given means we'll take as F. Let me read the options also. A is 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 6. Two fair dice are rolled. Then what is the conditional probability that first dice lands on 6? Given that sum of the numbers on the dice is 8. So given we take as F and probability of E, those which is asked, that will be your probability of E intersection F by PF, you know it. Or simply, if you will remember this, you can apply this, you will get the answers very quickly. What is N intersection F by NF? Now let me write the F. What is given? Given is sum of the numbers is, dice is 6. We are throwing two dice. So sample space is equal to your 36. Here we are getting sum as 8. So F will be which one? F will be sum of a sum is 8 means it will be 6, 2. It will be 2, 6. It will be 5, 3. It will be 3, 5. It will be 4, 4. Can it be more than that? No. So NF is equal to 5. Now you have to find N, E intersection F. N intersection F means you will find E, E in this F. What is E? E is your first dice shows 6. First dice shows 6. So where is it? First dice shows 6 means this is your first dice shows 6. So it is only 1. So N E intersection F is equal to 1. You have to select F from here only, not the whole sample space. So what will the probability of E condition F is equal to 1 by N E intersection F by NF. We have already written the formula. So it will be 1 by 5. So what is the answer? Answer is C. C is the answer. Next, two symmetric dice flipped with each dice having two sides pointed red, two painted black, one painted yellow and other painted white. What is the probability that both land on the same color? So there is a Ludo dice, there are two Ludo dice, two sides we have painted with your two side painted with red, two painted with black. So I am painting so that you can, two sides are red. Then two sides are black. Two sides are black. These two are black. And two sides are your, one is yellow and one is white. This one is yellow and this one is white. Okay. Similarly, for the second one is the same. Second same. What is the probability that both land in the same color? The options are 3 by 8, 2 by 9, 5 by 8, 1 by 3. So two sides are painted red, two sides are painted black, two painted yellow, one painted yellow, one painted white. Two are red, two are black, one is yellow, and one is white. And other one is the same thing. Two red, second one is two red, two black, one yellow, and one white. When it will be same, if all will be red, all will be, both will be red. That means out of this two, I'll get one, and out of this two, I'll get one. Then only they will be, both will be red, both red. This is the probability of red. Next, probability of black. What will be probability of black? Probability of black is same. Out of two, I'll get one, and for second, I'll out of two, I'll get one. that is a probability of black. Then probability of yellow. Probability of yellow is 1C1 into 1C1, I'm getting 1 only out of 1, I'm getting 1 out of 1, I'll getting 1. And probability of your white is same combination, 1C1 multiplies 1C1. So this will be 2C1, 2C1 is equal to 4, 2 into 2, because NC1 is your N, thus 2C1 is 2 into 2, that is 4. Here is also 4, 1C1 is 1. So it will get how much? It will be 1. This is your 1. So this is your NE, this event, NE, whole total. How many? It will be 4 plus 4 plus 1 plus 1. It will be 10. And what is the sample space when you are throwing 2 dice? It will be 36. So what is the probability? Probability of event A is equal to 4 plus 4 plus 1 plus 1. By 36. How much it will be? It will be 10 by 36. 10 by 36 is 5 by 18. Where is the answer? 5 by 18 is the answer. So this is C is the answer. Now coming to next question. There are n number of socks in a drawer, out of which 3 socks are red. If 2 socks are chosen at random, and probability that both selected socks are red is 1 by 2. What is the value of n? So there are total socks are your n number. And there are 3 red out of this. And we are taking 2 socks. So when I am taking 2 socks, so what is the sample space? Sample space will be your n combination 2, because this was the total number of socks. And out of 3, there are 3 reds out of this n. We are taking 2 socks, so this is the sample space. Question is, there are n socks in the drawer. We are taking 3 socks out of it, 2 socks out of it. 3 socks are red. 2 socks are chosen at random, so NC2. And probability that both selected are red. Both selected are red. What is the value of n? N. If the A is equal to 3, A is equal to 4, A is equal to 5, L is equal to 6. So what is NA? What is the event? Event is equal to the all are red. All are red. Both are red. Both are red means it will be selected from red. So it will be 3C2. So NA is equal to 3C2. So probability of A is equal to your NA by NS. So red is selected from red, 3C2, and we are selecting 2 out of N, it should be NC2. This is given to half. This is given as half. You have to find N. Now this is a question of combination only. What is 3C2? 3C2 is 3. Why? Now 3NC(n-1) is equal to your N. So 3C2 is your 3. And NC2 we write in this way, it will give you the easy answer. It is expression this. You can remember, you can write as a formula so that you will get the answers very quickly. So this will be n(n-1)/2. Is equal to half. So this 2 will be multiplied here, then it will be n(n-1) is equal to how much? It will be 12. Now don't make the quadratic equation, just compare. This will be your 3 into 4. So what is the bigger one? Bigger one is n. What is the bigger one? And here it is 4. So n is equal to 4. So instead of multiplying and getting the quadratic equation, it is easy if you can compare the continuous factor. Here n(n-1), it will be 4 into 3. So bigger one compare with bigger one. So n is equal to 4. So n is equal to 4, B is the answer. Next, 2 cards are chosen at random. from a deck of 52 playing cards. What is the probability that both of them have the same value? Two cards are chosen at random and both are having same values. That means here they are taken without replacement. Without replacement means when you will take, the sample space will be less. So how many values are there? How many values are there? There are 13 cards, so 13 values. So first, if we'll take one value, then it will be your, how much? 13 by 52, first event. When your second event is taking place, this is your first event. Second event is taking place, then there the values will be 12 only. Then what will the sample space? It will be 51. So first event is 13 by 52 multiplies. Second event will be 12 by 51. That means there are cards you took first. So this will be 13 by 52. We are not replacing it. So it will be only 12 values and the card will be 51. So they will be multiplied, taking as both are taking place. So now you can simplify 13 four times, 4 13 times, 4 3 times, then 3 17 times. What is the answer? Answer is 1 by 17. The option is 1 by 17 will be the answer. Let me repeat again. Two cards are chosen at random from a deck of 52 playing cards. What is the probability both of them has same value? Same value means there are 13 values. So first when we are taking, it will be 13 out of 52, we are taking 13 values. Then we are taking your, there will be how many? It will be 12. So 12 by 51. So answer is 1 by 70. In 8 throws of a die, 8 throws of a die, 5 or 6 considered as a success. The mean and standard deviation of the total number of success is respectively given by 8 by 13, 60 by 9, 8 by 3, 4 by 3, 4 by 3, 4 by 3, 4 by 3, 16 by 9. So let us learn the concept here. What is it? Now, this is the application of your binomial theorem. When we are throwing a die, this is taken as n. N is equal to 8. It is thrown 8 times. N is equal to 3. And what is success? Success is for getting 5 or 6. So P is equal to a probability of 5 or 6 when you are throwing a dice. So this will be 2 by 6. When it is 2 by 6, I can simplify. It will be 1 by 3. Then we have to find the Q. What is Q? Q is, if P is probability of success, P is success. P is probability of success, or what do you want, then Q is equal to probability of not success, or you can write failure, whatever it may be, we don't want. So P plus Q is always 1. So it will be 1 minus 1 by 3, that will be your 2 by 3. Okay. Now once you get this N, P, Q, then you can get mean, variance, standard deviation easily. You can remember as a formula. N into P is the mean. And NPQ is your variance. And NPQ square root is your standard deviation. So NP is equal to mean, NPQ is the variance, and square root of NPQ is the standard deviation. So you got all the things, now you can match the answer. So first mean is NP. NP is equal to how much? 8 into 1 by 3 is equal to 8 by 3. And what is NPQ? NPQ is equal to 8 by 3 into 2 by 3 because Q is 2 by 3. We have got it. Q is equal to 1 minus P. That will be 2 by 3. How much you are getting? 16 by 9. So this is your variance, but we need the standard deviation. So standard deviation is square root of your NPQ. So it will be square root of 16 by 9. How much? It will be your 4 by 3. So mean is, this is mean, 8 by 3. This is 4 by 3. So 8 by 3, 4 by 3. It is not the answer. 8 by 3, 4 by 3. So this is the answer. So B is the answer. Next question. A and B are two events such that not A, not B are mutually exclusive. If PA is 0.5, PV is equal to 0.6, what is the value of P, A given B, A condition B? A is 1 by 5, 1 by 6, 2 by 5, 1 by 3. P not A and no intersection not B is 0 because they are mutually exclusive. When two events are mutually exclusive, A and B are mutually, E and F are mutually exclusive, then your P, E intersection F is 0. So not A and not B are exclusive, so that is 0. So from this you can get another expression. What is it? Now P not A intersection not B, if you apply that De Morgan's law, it will be your 1 minus P A union B. Either or, complement is neither nor. So this is 0. So from this you can get probability of A union B is equal to 1. Now PA is equal to 0.5. PB is equal to 0.6. Question is P, A given B, you know that this is your P, A intersection B by PB. We need your P, A intersection B. So P, A is given, P, B is given, union we have got it. So this is equal to PA plus PB minus PA union B. So PA is equal to 0.5, 0.6 minus 1. So this will be 1.1 minus 1, just 0.1. So AA intersection B is 0.1 and P is 0.6. So what is the answer? Answer is 1 by 6. So 1 by 6, B will be the answer. Next, what is the probability that interior point in a circle is closer to the center than to the circumference? The options are 1 by 4, 1 by 2, 3 by 4. It cannot be determined. So there is a circle. Suppose it has the radius R. Now, any point on it, we'll find that it is closer to the center than to the circumference. Closer to circle means, then we can compare this, taking the half of this. If it is your greater than half of the radius, if the distance is greater than R, then it will be the close to circumference. Not R, R by 2. If distance is less than R by 2, this is your R by 2, B, this is R by 2. If distance is R by 2 is, then it will be close to center. So I'm marking the point R by 2. then if this is in this area, it will be in this area, then it will be closer to your center. So find the area. So first, what is the NS? Sample space is the whole area. It will be how much? Now pi r square. And your NA is equal to pi r by 2 square. Again, I repeat, what we are comparing? We are comparing that if it will be less than the radius, then it will be close to center. If it more than the radius, then it will be your close to circumference. So I compare with r by 2. And I took a circle with the radius r by 2. So that means if it is within this circle, then it is close to the center. If it is outside this circle, then it will be close to the circumference. So ns is equal to pi r square, n is equal to pi r square by 2. So what will be probability of A close to the circle? A is close to the circle. Close to north circle center. Then it will be pi r square by 4 by pi r square. How much you are getting? You are getting 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 is the answer. A and B are two events. If A and B are two events, then what is the probability that occurrence of either of event A or event B is A? PA plus PB, PA union B, PA intersection B, PA into PB. So this is very simple question and formula based question. Probability of either A or B is equal to simple probability of A union B. So B is the answer. I hope you have enjoyed and you have learned 15 questions. So subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you can learn more. Thank you for watching. Like the video.